Hey guys, and welcome to Dmitry Yargin Tech channel. Today we're going to talk about how to bypass the root check restrictions for Android applications. In this example, we're going to be using specific app that I have created for those purposes. Disclaimer, this is only for educational purposes, with basically analyzing the app and finding the weak points that we can modify to improve the app. First of all, what is the root check? Well, it's a type of check that's designed specifically to identify if your mobile device have been modified or not. Are you running custom firmware on your device or not? Why apps actually care about that? Well, there are specific type of apps such as finance or banking that want to make sure that data is securely transferred. That's why they want to make sure that your device is not modified and running a proper version of Android without specific modifications. If those apps actually identify that your phone is rooted, they will probably just, well, quit and decide not to operate in such environment because those apps cannot guarantee the safety of data transmission. And then you would probably ask, well, how to bypass those root check restrictions? And there are actually two ways. The first way to bypass this check is statically modifying the app. You basically want to rip apart this app, modify the specific place where it checks for this root access, then bundle it up together again and run it. The second one is actually dynamically changing the app during the runtime. So how it works? Your app actually sending the calls to operating system, in this case is Android, and then the specific script sending the wrong fake values to that, basically saying, okay, the phone is not rooted, everything is fine, you just believe it, you just believe me. So dynamically changing the app during the runtime. Today, we're going to take a look at both those approaches. Well, let's examine the app. First of all, I just type my username, my password, and I'm logging in. Actually, in the next video, we will bypass this login screen as well. That's why I'm demonstrating to you. Well, this is just a simple app. We have a web view. It says, welcome to vulnerable web view app. You can type your name. Let's say Dmitry. Show toast is gonna greet me. It can load the website and web view if I press this button. It can actually open the image screen. I can close it. Well, as you can see, it works fine on a non-rooted device. But if I launch a rooted device that is specifically created for this case, it's not gonna work. And I'm gonna show it to you. I'm gonna prove it to you. There's actually a rooted device. If we type adb root, and then we're gonna go adb shell. And if we type who am I, it's gonna say root. So this device is actually rooted. Let's try to launch the app here. We're gonna press this play button and it's launching fine here. I'm gonna type, let's say demo and my password. And as you can see, it says root access detected, closing applications. So it does not work on a rooted device. How would we actually trick the app to think that everything is fine and the phone is not rooted? Let's think about this. Quick note, please subscribe to the channel. If you like this video, press the like button and consider becoming a member. Because if you decide to be a member of our community, then you can actually get the source code for this application that we're examining today and you can play with it yourself. Okay, let's proceed with Dynamical Bypass first. We first need to install Frida server on our emulator. And if we go to GitHub Frida releases, we can actually search for Frida server and just install the applicable version binary for your emulator. In my case, it's x86 environment. So I basically copied this to my device and run it. I'm actually gonna show it to you right now. I don't want to show the whole process here because I already shown it in other videos. So please take a look at those. But I think in the future, I will show just a separate video just to simplify the process. All right, let's launch the emulator now. I actually created the simple script so I can pick the emulator I want and it's gonna start. So I'm starting the rooted emulator and let's make sure it's actually rooted. Okay, so this is the rooted emulator that I have used before. Now let's actually do the same adb root, adb shell. We actually need a rooted device because we need to work with the internals of the Android and actually communicate with the app. Without root access, we cannot do that. Or we need to install the Frida gadget and we're gonna talk about this in the next videos. So basically, let's go to cd data, cd local, cd tmp. Let's actually run the Frida server, shall we? Basically, this is the Frida server I got from the GitHub page. Frida server run. Okay, so this is running and now we can actually use our Frida scripts to bypass the root checks. Let's open a separate tab and now we can communicate with Frida server. But guys, in order to do that, we actually need to run Frida as well on the client side. And you need to actually go here, Frida page, and install Frida client on your machine. Like pip install Frida, for example, or npm install Frida. Without that, we cannot do this. So let's go back. Let's run this command, Frida ls devices. So we can see the emulator 5554, and it's running. Now we actually need to install the APK file here on this emulator. So this is the binary of the application. Let's open the terminal here and let's say adb install app debug apk. Okay, success. And if we run the app, it should start fine. Okay, we confirm that actually works. And now we need to actually execute the script that bypasses the root check dynamically. I decided to use this script. If you go to this website, you can actually find a very good script to bypass the root checks. And it's actually quite universal. You can use it for many apps. And this should work fine for our purposes. And it actually has the command that you need to run right here. Let's actually go ahead and run this script. I have this command pasted right here. And this is the package name. And it should succeed. Let's see. All right, let's go ahead and type the credentials. I'm going to press the login button, and guys, take a look here what happens. Pressing login button. As you can see, it all works fine. It actually started. All the root checks that app has tried to perform were stopped by this script. And the app thinks that the phone is not rooted, so it actually worked. So this is how we dynamically changed the way app works during the runtime. Let's go ahead and take a look how it works when we do it statically, so that we modify the APK file and see how it works. Okay guys, so we need specific app to decompile our APK file and understand what happens, what root checks are actually there in place. I recommend using JudX GUI version. Here it is. So JudX, you can grab it here and you can just launch and see it in this UI view. So I have it here. Let's just drag and drop the APK file and see how it looks like. Okay, what do we have here? We have a source code, but this source code is not exactly what developers have written. This is a reverse engineered version of this source code. So some things might be incorrect. Anyway, let's take a look and see, maybe there's something interesting for us. Let's go to com folder. Let's take a look at activities. There's a login activity right here, but the root check is not running during the login activity. By the way, this is what we call weak credentials, because as you can see, credentials are hard-coded into login activity, which is incorrect. This is actually one of the ways of looking at insecure applications and seeing the weak points. In this case, of course, it's a super insecure application, but this is not the point of this video. So we need to go to main activity, because I think that checks are running here, because of course there's a login activity and we don't see any checks here, only the username, and then of course the main activity is the next one. What's interesting in this main activity? First of all, we are looking at this onCreate method, and it has interesting methods right there. Is device rooted? As you can see, this is exactly what we need. This is how the root check is going through. And there are some other things that we can take a look here, but this is not as relevant. So we need to find the isDeviceRooted method. So here it is, isDeviceRooted, and it returns either true or false. If the app can find those paths, like here, then it says return true. Otherwise, it should return false. In our case here, we need to modify the app the way that it always thinks that it's false. So it always thinks that device is not rooted. So let's go ahead and modify the app. We need a specific tool to work with APK files, to unpack those and pack those back. So basically for this case, we need an APK tool. You can find this on that website. Installation guide is right here. You can follow it and install it on your machine. I already have it installed. This is an APK file. This is a terminal in this directory. We need to type APK tool, APK tool D, which means decompile. And then we specify the output directory, which is in this case going to be unpacked. And then we specify the name of the APK, appdebug.apk. We are done here, and the app is decompiled into smiley code, which could be named as the assembly of the Android. Here it is, basically. All right, and this is the smiley code. We need to find the specific part that we need, and we need to modify the main activity, right? Right. Let's see, smiley classes, maybe 3. Yes, this is probably what we need. Main activity smiley. Let's take a look here. Let's just search for super user. Yes, so this is what it looks for. System app super user APK. And let's see more. Yeah, bunch of those values right here. What we can do with those? Let's think. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe and press the like button if you liked it. Thank you and bye.